Game jam. What is it? Most likely experienced developers know what is it. But for beginners in the field of the game dev, I will explain now. Game jam is when a team of developers creates a game on a selected topic for a certain amount of time. You may think that you need to be a very cool developer to participate in the event, but this is not the case. After all, I was able to take part myself. I created the game in one day. And now I will show it to you. I didn't have much time and I needed to find a game jam with terms that were convenient for me. And I found one. This game jam went on for a whole week, but since I got a job this summer, I only had one day to create it. The topic of jam was gravity. I immediately came up with space, planets, meteors and similar nonsense, which I really like. For example, my first game was about space. Time was already passing, so I quickly came up with an idea and went to draw in as a sprite. As you already understood, the game will be about space, or rather about the planet which meteorites will fly. And to protect our planet, you will just need to click on this meteorite, after which it will explode. If this was the end of my idea, then the game would be no different from the other mass of games about space. So, I decided to add hardcore to my game. I have created a semi-transparent spherical that will rotate around the planet. You will never guess, but this will be the zone within which the stellate should be located, which will be controlled by our player. Meteorites are flying faster and faster. The zone is spinning faster and faster. It's a pretty hardcore game, but I like it. In Unity, the first thing I did was to place all the objects on the stage and write a small script for our planet, which was supposed to constantly rotate and when it collided with a meteorite, it would collapse. It would be logical to add meteorites and a spawner for them next. So, I did. And he began to implement the mechanics of the satellite's operation. Everything was as simple as possible. The satellite rotates at a certain distance from the Earth. If it touches the collider of an unknown spherical with its collider, then the satellite explodes and therefore the game ends. It was also possible to lose from the destruction of the satellite by a meteorite. I made a little shaking of the camera when a meteorite hit the Earth, made the scoring and even made an original way to restart the game. When you lose one of three ways, namely due to the destruction of the Earth, the destruction of the satellite or the satellite's descent from orbit, the meteorite spawner is replaced by the restart button spawner. Now it looked like a game and it was not even a shame to present it in the competition, but I decided that without a particle, the game is not a game. I added stars to the background, created an explosion effect. The last thing I did was post-processing. I created the lighting for the game and now it looked much better. You can compare it yourself. Oh yes, I almost forgot. Sounds. Sounds are a very important part of any video game. You should know this if you watched the previous video where I voiced my game with my mouth. I went to Free Sound where I found music for the background, as well as the sound of an explosion. I quickly added them to the project and with a couple of lines of code, the game acquired a completely different atmosphere. Everything was ready. I imported the game into HTML and uploaded it to itch.io. Beautifully designed the page, at least it seems so to me, and sent the project to the competition. Right now you can follow the link in the description and test my project yourself and maybe even vote for it. This video ends. Thank you all for watching. See you in new videos.